Number 19, She's Moonlight says, how can I share the gospel with people who have a schizoaffective disorder and severe depression? I know a man who can't comprehend that he has worth and value. How can I show him God loves him? Okay, well, I mean, obviously your first question is a really big one, and I don't have huge answers for you there. Because I don't have great knowledge of schizoaffective disorder, and I think that severe depression is also something where it's like I approach those people individually. Like I learn what I don't know about schizoaffective disorder can be covered by me learning about you. I know about you. I know how you think. Okay. I don't need to just have a technical analysis of a disorder, which could help, but I can learn the person. I had a buddy who was schizophrenic and we just talked about it. And he would tell me things like, hey, Mike, if I ever don't call you, if I ever am kind of like standoffish, it's probably because I'm starting to think that you hate me. Like sometimes I think that. So like maybe just, you know, give me a call and tell me that you don't. And so I learned in that relationship, like if he started becoming distant, I had to like do that for him. And you see what I mean? Like know the person, that helps. Know the person, understand them. I think as far as the question of how can I show him God loves him? I think the answer to this is ultimately the cross. And if this feels like a cliche, it's only because we're missing the point about it. The cross shows us God loves us. And so when we want to show other Christians God loves them, we should show them the cross. So one of the best ways is to demonstrate just the cross. Talk about Jesus, like how he lived the perfect life and he died on the cross for our sins. Would you die for someone you don't love? Would you take their sin upon yourself just so that they could be redeemed? He took on our humanity. He took on our wickedness. He took on our sin. The cross is what tells me God loves me when my heart doesn't want to tell me God loves me. The cross is what tells me God loves me when my mind is going off on some tangent and some other little, oh yeah, but I'm like, dude, Jesus died on the cross. Do not push aside his sacrifice by doubting his love for you. Another way God shows his love for us is by choosing wicked people to forgive. There's the thief on the cross who's there being crucified. He's like, I deserve this. So you might ask your friend, do you deserve that? Do you deserve to be crucified? Well, I probably do. Maybe I do. I don't know. But Jesus still loved him enough to forgive him and say, you're going to be with me today in paradise. Or I've done bad things. I've thought horrible things. I've done wicked things. Okay, well, what about Paul the apostle? Like God literally picked Paul the apostle because he was a bad guy. I don't know if you know this. Like one of Paul's qualifications for apostleship was total bad guy. And he even says that God chose him as an example so that people would look at Paul and say, if God could use someone who was basically assisted murdering people in the church, persecuting the body of Christ, putting in prison those who are, you know, Jesus says, you're persecuting me, to Paul. And Paul says he did this so that people would know he loves them and has grace for them, that they would see an example in me, the chief of sinners, the worst of sinners, so that even if you look at yourself and think, no, I'm too bad, you'd be like, well, that's why he picked Paul, because he was bad. If we think we have to be good enough for God to love us, we have misunderstood a fundamental aspect of the gospel of Christ. Think about it.